of Internal Revenue.
And the Chief Justice was already summoned in order to appear in that investigation? Or you are just still evaluating
them? Sir, I think you should ask the Chief Justice about it. He would be the, because whatever investigation we're conducting, it's confidential. And it should be only the party whom we're investigation.
If Your Honor, please, the witness here is should not be allowed to argue with counsel. I'm asking him here for a fact.
Just answer the question.
The witness is answering, Your Honor.
If you know the answer, please answer it. If not, just say so.
Sir, it is a confidential information under Section 71 and
The question is, are you investigating?
Sir, I already said am investigating.
All right. What was the next question?
So, without the witness, without the Chief Justice being informed, is that what you wanted to tell the Honorable Court?
No, that's not what I was trying to say.
Oh, what is, will you kindly tell the Honorable Court what you meant by conducting the investigation without the knowledge of the particular person involved, more specifically Chief Justice Corona?
Misleading, Your Honor, without the knowledge. The witness said, please ask the Chief Justice, because this is confidential according to the witness.
Let the witness answer.
Sir, may I ask for a waiver from the counsel of the Chief Justice that I can answer? Because it's confidential information, sir.
The tendency of the question, Madam Witness, is, are you conducting an investigation of the Chief Justice? And you said
sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
And is that, are you obligated to
inform
the Chief Justice that you're conducting an investigation bearing on his income tax position? And you said it's confidential, meaning you did not, isn't it? You did not inform him.
We have informed him, and I think he is in receipt of a notice that we are investigating
him.
Did you
send a notice to him that he is under investigation?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's all. You just explained the procedure in investigation of tax income tax returns.
Yes, sir. We issued a letter of authority to him.
A letter of authority to your agents to investigate him?
Yes, sir.
No, not to him, you know.
No, the letter...
Did you supply him with the letter of authority that is under investigation?
Yes, sir.
Precisely.
We issued...
Please answer the question so that hindi tayo nagtatagal dito eh.
Yes, sir. We issued a letter of authority addressed to
your
Chief
agents,
Justice.
Your agents?
No. There's a letter of authority notice that we sent to the Chief Justice telling him that certain revenue officer is auditing his income tax return.
So you notified him that there is an ongoing internal revenue investigation bearing on his income tax?
Yes, sir. Okay. We issued that after the hearing.
What hearing?
Sir, when I was called here for the impeachment hearing, sir.
After the hearing here?
Yes, sir.
What hearing was that? When you appeared here?
Yes, sir. January 26 or 25.
So it is only now that you are conducting an income tax investigation of the Chief Justice?
Yes, sir.
Not before?
Sir, before we even determine whether we will really go.
All right. Yeah. Just for the information of the court, what year is involved in your investigation?
Starting from taxable year 2002? From 1992 up to 2010.
Are you conducting a net worth investigation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Proceed.
I'm showing to you, Madam Commissioner, three letters of purport to be letter of authority, which we request, Your Honor, respectively as Exhibit 56, 57, 58, and 59, Your Honor, for the defense. Kindly go over the same whether and tell the Honorable Court whether that is the letter. I'm sorry, palagi ako. Pasensya ka na. Your Honor, please, we notice that the witness is not supposed to discuss this.
Counsel for the prosecution, please do not.
The other gentleman with an eyeglass, Your Honor.
During cross-examination.
Sir, he is my chief of staff, so he brings the original document.
Yeah, but
therefore, I should consult him whether... I don't have the original, but I believe that this is the letter of authority that we issued for Maria Carla Castillo Corona from taxable year January 1, 2007 to December 31, 2010. For Renato Corona from January 1, 1997 to December 31, 2010. For Cristina Rocco Corona from January 1, 2001 to December 31, 2010. And from Constantino Castillo III from January 1, 1998 to December 31, 2010.
And you are proceed. May we now continue, Your Honor?
Proceed.
And you are proceeding with that investigation, notwithstanding dependency of these impeachment proceedings involving the SAL and the income tax return of the Honorable Chief Justice Corona.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You did not find anything objectionable in that, which may smack of persecution to the eyes of the public.
No, sir. I think
nothing wrong with it.
No, sir. The public expect us to do it, so there's nothing
wrong.
Which
public are you speaking of?
The public expect us to implement the National Internal Revenue Code, and from the moment there's something wrong,
we should
investigate it, sir.
No, but you had been speaking of the public. May we be informed whom do you refer to by the word public?
The public we serve as revenue collector of the Philippines.
The public, I
didn't get serve that. As revenue collector of the Philippines, sir. Whoever that public might be, it may include you.
Thank you, Mr. Madam Witness. But what I'm questioning is the propriety of that investigation being conducted now while this impeachment proceedings is going on, covering the same subject matter.
Sir,
you did not find that? I'm sorry.
Sir, the alternative is to be told that we are sleeping on our job. Mm-hmm.
And
so I think the better alternative for the Bureau of Internal Revenue is to do its job.
All right. So much so that if there is a complaint involving any of the prosecutor here and the rest of the other members thereof, you will investigate the case.
Of course, sir. Yes,
thank
sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Then, that's all with the witness, Your Honor.
Redirect.
That's all.
Yeah.
Redirect.
With your kind permission, Your Honor. Yes, Your Honor.
Proceed.
During your cross-examination on January 26, 2012, as recorded on page 46 of the journal, the following exchange took place. Quote, question, Mr. Cuevas, now examining the SAL end of Chief Justice Corona, which you saw while you were here already to testify. Based thereon, kindly tell the Honorable Court whether you noticed any discrepancy or falsity in said SAL N. Answer by Ms. Jacinto Henares. I noticed a lot of discrepancy in the SAL N that I saw, that the media gave me, because I measure it in relation to the SAL N I have to submit. End of quote. My question is, showing to you these documents previously marked as Exhibit A up to N-1.
What document is that?
Inclusive.
What document is that?
SAL ends, Your Honor. Huh? Are these the SAL ends of Chief Justice Renato Corona, copies of which were given to you by that media person while you were in the holding room of the Senate? on January 19, 2012?
No basis, Your Honor. Why we are no sorry basis? To object, Your Honor. And why we will explain if we are allowed.
Why no basis?
Because there are very... There
I
are
quoted
very,
the transcript.
Yeah, you are quoting, but there is only one SLN that was discussed in that question. You are now presenting a lot of SLN, so no basis.
Generic, plural. The witness can clarify that, Your Honor. Whether it was just 1 year SLN or from 2002 up to 2010. That's why I'm asking the witness to clarify.
Witness, may answer, come on.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Witness examining the documents shown to him by the private prosecutor, Your Honor.
Yes, yes, sir. It seems to be the same document, sir.
It seems to me.
The same document to what?
To the SALN that was given to me by the media press. Person that was marked supposedly as exhibits.
Given to you by?
Media.
One of the media person when they tried to interview me.
Why? The Bureau of Internal Revenue does not have a copy of the SALN.
Sir, the National Internal Revenue will only have, the Bureau of Internal Revenue will only have a copy of SALN when we request from the custodian of the SALN.
So you did not have the SALN before it was given to you by the media?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
So proceed.
Thank you, Your Honor.
These SALNs are for what years?
From 2002 up to 2010, when he was already a member of the High Court, Your Honor.
2002, 2003, 2004, 2005, 2006, 2007, 2008, 2009, 2010.
Thank you, Your Honor. Yes, Your Honor.
All right. Of the Chief Justice?
Of the Chief Justice,
thank
Renato
you, because
Corona.
He's being blamed for allegedly, he's being faulted for allegedly not filing his SALN.
So,
it now appears that
so the Chief Justice filed for those
yes.
years.
As
for
per exhibits A.
No. The court would like to know.
Yes, Your Honor.
Those are SALN of the Chief Justice for those years mentioned.
But tainted
no,
by.
No, for this. Just answer the question.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. So, what is your comment?
Tainted by violations as to accuracy, truthfulness, and timeliness.
That is your opinion.
Your Honor, I was just...
You have not shown yet that they're inaccurate. So I'm just asking a factual statement from you. Those
yes,
are SAL and from for the Chief Justice for the years mentioned.
Yes,
those are facts.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay.
May I proceed, Your Honor? I invite your attention once again, Madam Witness, to the SALN, which you already identified and previously marked as Exhibits A up to N-1 inclusive. What were the discrepancies you noticed or noted in this SALN?
Wait a minute. I think...
I'm sorry, Your Honor.
Is this witness competent to testify on those discrepancies?
Yes, Your Honor, because the
why?
Defense...
Why?
The defense, no less...
No, why?
Because
why?
The...
Why is she competent?
She is filing her own SALN. The defense qualified her as an expert witness during their cross-examination, Your Honor.
Counsel, you did not qualify this as an expert witness. There is a procedure to qualify a person as an expert witness. Please.
I am fully aware of that.
Please do so. You are directed to qualify here as an expert witness.
Thank you, Your Honor. Madam Witness, how long have you been in the government service?
This is no longer redirect, Your Honor. The coverage of redirect, Your Honor, are only matters taken up in the cross. This we have never.
I'm complying. That is,
we ask the witness very categorically well whether she is testifying solely on the basis of the document.
Actually, may I suggest, Mr. Counsel, for the prosecution, produce evidence aliunde to prove the discrepancies.
Your Honor, please, just one brief manifestation.
I'm suggesting this to you. That's the procedure.
Yes, Your Honor, but may I also be allowed to respectfully point out, Your Honor, the conclusive presumption under Section 2, Rule 131 of the Rules of Court, which applies supplitorily, and which is the applicable provision in the absence of a similar rule. In the absence of a similar rule in the Senate impeachment rules.
What is the presumption?
The conclusive presumption is whenever a party has, by his act, by his own declaration, act or omission, intentionally and deliberately led another to believe a particular thing true and to rely upon such belief, he cannot, in any litigation arising out of such declaration, act or omission, be permitted to falsify it. Hindi po kami ang nag-qualify sa witness po. Defense counsel ang nagtanong sa ating testigo kung ano-ano ang mga discrepancies nakita sa SALN ni Chief Justice Corona. Seryoso pong pagtatanong yun. Hindi natin masabi na nagbibiro lang yung si Justice Cuevas. Ngayon po, bakit natin pigilan, and I say this with all due respect, bakit pipigilan ng defense ang katotohanan na lilitaw dito? Tinanong nila ang witness.
Let the witness answer.
Thank you, Your Honor.
For year 2002, there's 9 properties that were not reported in his SALN. The discrepancies. Then for year